Hey guys, today I will be following a tutorial on something to paint with my new painting kit. So, let's get into it. Okay. We need to be painting some mountains, I guess. Well, let's start.
I guess I hope you grab a few paints and some brushes and come along and paint with us. If you've been with us before, first of all, I'd like to thank you for inviting me back again. So I tell you what, let's have them graphically run all the colors across the screen that you need to do this painting with.
Titanium white. I'll be right back, guys. All right, I am back, guys. With 12 colors. All right, let's start painting. I'm back. All right. Well, I already technically did that. I'm gonna go make this water bigger. Because I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be water. Using a lot of blue in this painting. I'm noticing that. Right, that's good.
Very gently blend it to take out the brush strokes. Come right across the bottom. And we have a happy little sky. That easy. That easy.
This isn't turning out good.
Very strong. Heat up your whole world. Okay, load a lot of paint into the brush. Let's go up here now. Maybe there's a happy little clouds that just sort of float right around in the sky and have fun. Just sort of mix them up on here. The clouds are very free. Just let them play. Let them play. Maybe it comes right off in here and goes off the top of the canvas. Wherever. Wherever. This is your world. Kind of illusion that you want in your world. There we go. And these are just little floaters, little happy clouds. And you can put as many or as few as you want.
We'll take a cloud. That looks good.
Be sure it's dry. 2-inch brush, and I'm going to just gently blend it using tiny little circular strokes. Tiniest little strokes. Just blend this together.
just for reference. Just for reference, these are his. These are mine. I mean, I am only 7. I mean, 8. I'm used to saying 7 because I just turned 8. Alright.
Just sort of mix it up.
Oh, this paint dries fast.
This sort of fluffs the cloud. Just fluffs it right up. Like so. And then very lightly. There we go. Isn't that fantastic? You can do a happy little cloud that easy. Okay. Shoot, we're just going right along here. Tell you what, I lived in Alaska, nearly 14 years or so. I really like mountains, so let's do a fantastic little mountain. I'm gonna take some black.
I don't have that paint supply.
Some Van Dyke brown. We'll put some alizarin crimson in there too. Be careful with the crimson, or your mountain will turn purple, which is all right. That's all right. They wrote a beautiful song about purple mountains. Pull it out very flat.
So, what did he need? There. This is fun.
Pollution and all those things that break up and diffuse light. See? Because this is wet, so you can just move this paint, you can pull it. You can move it all over the canvas. If this was a dry canvas, you'd be in Agony City right now. There we go. Well, let's go back to the night. And let's put some snow on this mountain. For that, I'll take the titanium white, pull it out. Very flat.
I'll just wash this off. Oh! I'll just wash this off. Yes! No! No. I still here. Okay. Now we need some white. I don't have enough white. Be right back. Titanium white.
decisions. If you're right-handed, normally it's easier for the light to come from the right side. So let's go right here. Touch, no pressure. Just the weight of the knife. No pressure. See there? Let it float right down the side of that mountain. Look at there. Look at there. Just follow the angles in your mountain. Float. Absolutely.
Oh, he wants to do shadows? That's better.
I'll come distinctly through. See how it pushes that peak right back? A sneaky out. It's easy to do. You can do it. You can do it. There's no big secret here. We'll show you everything that you need to paint fantastic paintings.
Does not look that good.
It does actually.
This is one of the ways that you create depth and distance.
Jules, can you please just leave? I need more titanium. I'm running out of this fast. Fast.
And that's not bad when you're learning. Take an old canvas and start at the top and paint all the way down to the mountains and just zip them right off and do it again. That's the way you learn. If there's a secret to anything, it's practice. Just practice. Thank you.
football hills.
So then, I will start off and mix up some color. I'll just use this mountain color and let's put a little, let's put some white with it and see what we have. So that's just mainly some blue and black, and there's some crimson. And to that, I'm going to add the least little touch, of sap green, just to give it a little greenish color. Part of here, I'm going to add some white and make it even lighter. This is an oval brush. Maybe we can get a close-up shot of it. It's a little different. See, it's sort of round. This is an oval. It's a little different. Watch here, though. I'm going to fill it full of that color we just made. Just really load it full of paint. Okay, let's go right up here. Now, there you have to make a big decision. Let's say a little footy hill is right here. And all I'm doing is just tapping. Isn't that fantastic? Look at all the little things it makes in there. Looks like just the tops of thousands of little trees far off in the distance. Look at that. Look at there. Look at that. See? Isn't that a super easy way to make little footy hills? Now with a clean dry brush, I want to create some mist at the base of this. All I'm going to do is just tap the base. Just tap the top. Stands out as things get closer to you in the landscape. They should get darker and darker in color. Look at that. See there? Maybe. There. See how easy that is? Painting does not have to be difficult. Does not have to be difficult. You don't have to be blessed by Michelangelo at birth to be able to paint. You can do it. It's fun. Sells paintings. Let's have some fun here. We'll take some black, Prussian blue, sap green. We'll throw in some lizard crimson too. What the heck? Good dark color. Should look black. Clean the knife. Okay. Now I'll use a fan brush. Load it full of paint. A lot of paint on both sides. Let's go right up here. Maybe there's some little evergreens that live back here in the distance here. I'm just going to take a tap downward. There's some little trees. They're not all evergreens, maybe. There's all kinds of trees. Just tap downward. Tap it downward. See there? And these are a little closer, so you're beginning to see a little more detail. Detail.
Alright, now that we're at this step, I'm gonna go solo. Alright, let's make some islands. Actually, let's make one big island. make a path. So if we grab some of the midnight black, the brown, that, and the crimson red. Draw a happy little flag. Little house. What's that, a dog? Before I do anything else, let's add the path to it. So, this is what we ended up with. So, that. Like, subscribe. No, no. Like, subscribe, do all that great stuff, and I'll see you next time. Good.